Hey guys, this is part two. I had to switch over to my other camera to get this. I'm going to explain to you guys how I got started. So what you're going to do is, once you get your canvas, you're going to count all the squares that are whole. So each 10 by 10 square is one square. So you'll count across from either left to right or right to left, however you feel comfortable, and then you need to count from the bottom all the way up to the other corner, but they have to be the full squares. My word chart was 150 by 200, so my 150 left me with two whole squares on the side, and my 200 side left me with five whole squares on each side. Now, I know some of you have a 300 count by 150 or whatever. You'll just flip it and it'll be the whole length, because that's 300 all the way across, up and down from me here. But you want to make sure that you have 1 inch to 2 inches on each side of your rug for when you're tacking it back and making the frame for it when you're done. Because when you're done, you're going to end up cutting some of the extra off. But when you are completely done, you want to focus on just the rug. So if it was tacked, it would look like this. I do not recommend going over 280 just on the 60 by 36 canvas, which is what I'm working on. Otherwise, you're not going to have that extra inch or two to tack it. It'll be really rough and it'll be really hard for you to work it, because if it was the 300, you would be working all the way to this edge right here. When I work mine at the beginning, I count all my squares from right to left, and then I find my center from the right to left, and then from top to bottom I find my center, and then I count to see where my extras are, and then that's when I find my playing field for my word chart in this case. Also, to save your ends here from fraying and coming apart, like this part right here, I don't know if you guys can see that very well, but this part right here, bring it a little closer to you here. This part right here, I would recommend taking masking tape and going all the way around, tenting it all the way around so that you're not fraying like this, because that is a pain in the butt later on. If you guys have any more questions, please let me know. I am more than welcome, or more than happy actually, to walk you through this process. Even if you are just learning how to latch hook, that's great. I learned a long time ago, fell in love, and then I did it as a job for a couple years, and then I just started to, you know, fall out of it. But hooks, somebody was asking about hooks earlier. I know I posted a picture, but this is the hook that I use right here. It's a regular skinny handled hook, and the latch hook is right there. And I prefer this one over my big handled hook here. This is for people who have arthritis, pretty much, or need a comfy grip to work. But I can't tell you how many times I've had to replace my hooks, because I work my hooks a lot, because this part breaks. So, and lucky, these are cheap. These are like $1.99 up to like $4. These were like, this one right here was like $8. But you can buy all of your materials at your local craft store. They will be in the yarn section, but like behind it. You just have to look at what they got compared to what you need for your charts. Like I said, if you guys have any questions, I am more than happy to help you. And I can't wait to continue on this journey with you guys. And I'll see y'all later.